Hey guys, I'm back with an animated review. Today I'll be covering one of my favorites, I guess, from the animated line. I think it's really cool. Not a fan of the whole way it's done, but animated Shockwave / Long Arm Prime. This is him in his long arm mode to start off with. I like that. There's a hair on his head. Must have been teabagged. I like the whole concept. There's another one. I blame Ratchet. I like the concept that there is a Decepticon infiltrating the Autobot ranks, and he's worked himself up to like the high intelligence officer. He is a prime. I like that they incorporate that where he has four different modes, but I wish they could have done it better, because it's really the Autobots. It kind of shows you why, you know, they're puny. It makes you wonder how they won the war. At least I think they did. When they can't spot the difference between Shockwave and Long Arm. But this Long Arm, in his crane mode, he has these little feet on the front here, and little feet in the back. Just stand him up. That's about all he does. Yeah, he's a crane. He can't really, you know, I'm not sure if he walks as a crane in the show. He doesn't have wheels, so I don't know if he's stationary. How's he going to help out? But he's a crane, and he even has a little dinky little hook. Isn't that cute? That's really it for this mode. It's kind of it's not that special. He does have a Decepticon mode. Take his back legs and straighten them out. The little feet on the ends fold flat, and then these little parts here are going to slide up to get flat. Okay, it's looking more tank-like. So then, I meant to say the crane, you can tilt it up and down and move it around. Oh, but look, that reveals the insignia, so it's kind of pointless. Pull back on this little trigger, and the cannon shoots forward. And now he is an actual tank. Okay, now, you can also flip these forward. The instructions don't really, mention it, but the box art doesn't. But you can flip this forward to make them look a little more menacing. Now, I don't really like this idea because he looks almost exactly the same. Yes, he has a gun now. Woo! Now, you know, think of the scenario, okay? Shockwave's on a mission. Rumble, 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 rumble. Shooting up the place. Bang, bang, bang. Turret flies off and just goes in its own scouting out victims. And after he's done, he gets a call from Ultra Magnus. Long Arm, we need for you to go to this area and, you know, clean up duty. Okay, rolls in, transforms to crane mode. Wouldn't they be able to spot that it is the exact same vehicle, just little tweaks here and there? I don't like that. The tank mode, I think, looks really cool. The crane mode, I think it was more of a second, kind of decision type thing. You know, they wanted to have the tank. They knew they wanted to have the tank. But they're like, okay, what can we turn this into? And then Bob in the back, pipes up, puts his pipe down, and, crane. So yeah, that's it for the tank mode. It does have wheels, so it does move around. Yay. Turret can go up and down, so it is part of the crane. It actually, it looks good. The Decepticon insignia looks nice on the front. I know it's not the animated style, get over it. And it can rotate all the way around if you so desire. And it can fly off and attack enemies at will. Very nice little sneak attack. But transform into Long Arm. Let me just kind of zoom back a little bit here. He's pretty much transformed for the most part. All you have to do, separate the legs of this little panel in the back. Just like this. See, they separate. Fold his legs down. Fold this panel in. Fold the legs down. Fold this panel in. He reach inside and pull out his little feetums. He needs his feetums to stand like that. They don't really click out, which I wish they would. But, oh well. And he's not there yet, don't worry. Get his little hands up now. Before I comment more, maybe I should wait till I get the hands up ready. Yeah, I'll do it later. Got his little arms out. Slide them down like this. Like this. Fold these little panels in. Again, now I'm going to talk about the hands. His hands are kind of goofy. They're on this little ball joint. It's that little rubbery plastic type material that, it works, it's nice. This hand I have no problem with. It rotates freely, it's nice, it's loose, cool. This one, and I've heard I'm not the only one who has this problem. This hand, it's like the ball is either bigger or the socket is smaller, because you cannot rotate it without feeling you're going to force it. And mine actually just in the first transformation started cracking right in the base there. So my advice, if you want to rotate the hand, which you will have to for as alternate mode, slide the hand down first, okay, and then, you know, rotate it however you have to. It does seem a little easier, you know. Just, you don't want to break that, because I don't know if you can really glue that kind of stuff together. It's that kind of material that it's, you know, scary to mess with, I guess. But on the transformation, finish it. Get his legs bent upright at this kind of angle, like this. And there you have Long Arm Prime. Or Long Arm, if you prefer. Make sure I have him standing right. He's not bad looking. You know, he looks okay. He doesn't have a neck. Oh, this little panel back here, I leave mine facing up, so if I do decide to attach the crane, which I think in the instructions it says just to leave the crane on his back, kind of like this, which looks fine and dandy, you know, gives him a tail, until you see the front that, wait a minute. And yes, I'm sure you could make a joke about pointing forward and that kind of stuff. I'm not going to mess with that too much. This mode's okay. You know, it's not his better of the modes, but it works. He has no light piping. His arms have full movement. He has an elbow. His hands, you can move, but it's flimsy. You don't want to really mess with it, so you can't really do much with his hands anyway. His legs has pretty good movement at the top. My one complaint is this whole thing is just kind of loose, this whole area, so it does kind of flop around. This thing pops up a lot. His knee has movement, which is nice. You know, it's okay. It's not bad. It's definitely, I think it's an afterthought to the whole Shockwave idea. And if you want to, you can take his crane, put it on his arm, but it makes him a little more like his other part. And of course, why would you want to have a crane on your arm? It's just, it's kind of, why not use your hands? You have two of them. Use them. That's what Primus gave you. Gonna pull this off because it's just stupid. Now into Long Arm. No. Now into Shockwave mode. I guess you could start, pull his legs down, get a good little grip on him, and just pull, and you'll see these little panels and the whole legs pull down. You have to give it a nice little tug. There you go. That little bitch actually helps quite a bit. Once you have those down, grab these little panels, these little scythe things, which of course aren't an issue until I have to move them. They fold up, and then they fold on the top like this. And same with the other one, fold it up, fold it to the top. Now, take his legs, the lower half under his knee, rotate them around. You know, it's just, it bugs me how close he looks to Long Arm. It's just, hey, Long Arm got taller and skinnier. Awesome. Reach in the sides here, pull out his hands to extend them outwards. Like this, makes his arms a little bit longer. Long Arm. Rotate these around. Now, take his hands, you're going to, for this arm at least, fold it inside. And then fold it so it's like this. So when you extend his top fingers, oh, it's a full hand. Isn't that cool? Yes, it is cool. It's mighty cool. This hand, you can, you know, do whatever you want. Just rotate like this. It's fine. Do these little dongles out. Have his arms like this. So he's pretty much, you know, just a freak of nature. Here's what I'll do his head next. Now I'll do these next. Shoulders, you're going to put them back like they were for his tank in alternate mode. Stay in there. Okay. So he's, I don't know, his arms are longer. He has, you know, that going for him, but they're up higher, so it doesn't really make much sense. Grab the head, and you're going to extend it outwards, like this, all the way out. And then fold his little antlers up, because Shockwave has antlers for some apparent reason. I don't know why. Last but not least, flip his little insignia around to Decepticon. Now, this is his better mode. I like this mode a whole lot more than the Long Arm one. Take his little cannon, flip these little red doolollies forward, and then clip it to his arm if you want the whole G1 Shockwave has a cannon for an arm thing going. Which, yes, this mode looks very nice. He is nice. He's pretty tall. I think someone said he's maybe a hair shorter than a Leader Megatron. Maybe even taller. I'm not entirely sure. I don't have the figure. He looks very nice. He does lean quite a bit, though. Now, my complaint, though, is why can't the Autobots look at him and see he has Long Arm's chest? See, he leans a lot. That's my own problem. He's kind of loose. He has long arms, hands. Of course it's like long arm. I forgot to flip up his shoulder panels. Okay. Long arm where? Well, see long arm, I just see Shockwave. You know, it's just... Now, I don't know. I'm hoping maybe Shockwave hasn't made much of an appearance in the show yet. Maybe the Autobots don't know of his existence. You know, maybe they just know Long Arm, and Shockwave is so good that he doesn't even switch to Shockwave mode at all. I don't know. I don't know these things. I want to know, though. I want to know why the Autobots don't know that Shockwave is Long Arm. That bugs me quite a bit, because they look identical, almost. Yes, the limbs are longer. Yes, he's skinnier, but it's the same. Articulation's about the same. He has the same, you know, the same rotation for the shoulders. He has a new elbow joint thrown in. His other one, it moved at this little angle, so he does have kind of two joints for his lower arm now if he wants. The legs are about the same. He still has knees, still has all the hip movements. His head can rotate now, though. So you can get him, you know, looking up, looking down, looking all the way around. He even has light piping. Try not to blind the camera. There you go. That's kind of cool, little light piping effect, you know. Imagine if you're doing a stop motion, that would actually look kind of cool, you know, just have that little, you know, Megatron, hello, kind of thing going. He definitely is a whole lot better in Shockwave mode than Long Arm mode. And I definitely would recommend him for your animated collection, because he should be a bigger character coming up, I hope, shortly. But that is about it. I would recommend him, but, you know, there is a purple variant coming out that makes him a little more G1-ish, even though he has the exact same figure, just purple. So you may want to have this one transformed in Long Arm mode, and then have the purple one in Shockwave mode, maybe to help distinguish them a little different from each other. But I don't think it's really going to help much. They still look the same. I like it, though. I mean, I don't want to sound like I'm bashing on it. I just think the Long Arm concept is kind of stupid. But that's it, guys. I am done. I hope you enjoyed the review just a little bit. I'm playing with this gun. It's bending.
Bendy gun, bendy.
Have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.